With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
The question is, the wave function for 3s and 3pz orbitals are given. Okay, these are the wave function for 3s and 3pz orbitals. Okay, where sigma is equal to 2zr upon n a naught. Okay, where a naught is the first Bohr radius, z is the charge number of the nucleus, r is the distance from the nucleus. From this we can conclude. So basically, let us solve the wave function in order to find out the radial nodes as well as the angular nodes for the given orbitals. Okay, so let us consider the wave function for 3s orbital. Okay, so for nodes, whether it is radial or angular, our psi function psi 2s is equal to 0 if we are talking about the 3s orbital. Okay, so psi 3s is equal to 0. Now we are given psi 3s is equal to, so this is the wave function for the 3s. So this expression needs to be equated to 0. So these are basically constants. Okay, these are constants which are non-zero constants. Okay, and this is our exponential function which cannot be equal to 0. Okay, so the only expression that can be equal to 0 is this expression. Okay, so basically it will reduce to sigma square minus 6 sigma plus 6 equal to 0. So this is basically the quadratic equation. So the roots for this equation will be given by sigma is equal to plus minus root b square minus 4 into a into c divided by 2a. Because we are using simply this formula for the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c, our x will be equal to minus b plus minus root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Simply this quadratic formula. So on simplifying this, we will get the values of sigma is equal to 6 plus minus root 12 divided by 2, which is simply equal to 3 plus minus root 3. Okay, so we are having sigma is equal to 3 plus root 3 and sigma equal to 3 minus root 3. And we are given that sigma is 2zr upon n a naught, 2zr upon n a naught, where n is 3, okay, is equal to 3 plus root 3, 3 minus root 3. So our radial nodes for 3s orbital will be 3 plus root 3 times 3 a naught divided by 2z and 3 minus root 3 times 3 a naught divided by 2z. So these are the radial nodes for the 3s orbital, and there is no angular nodes basically. Okay, so here the total number of nodal surfaces are basically 2 and all are radial nodes. Okay, now let us consider the nodal surfaces for 3pz orbital. So again, using the same concept, we can write that psi p3z psi 3pz equal to 0. So our wave function for 3pz orbital will be, so this is the wave function for the 3pz orbital. So here our d is constant, which is non-zero, and this is exponential function, which is again non-zero. So the term that can be equated to zero are this term and this term. Okay, so basically we are having 4 minus sigma equal to 0 or cos theta equal to 0. Okay, considering the first term, it will be equal to sigma equal to 0 comma 4, but we are talking about non-zero radius, because we all know that at r equal to 0 our electron density will be 0. Okay, so our this solution will be neglected. So it is having the value of sigma equal to 4, which is the acceptable solution. So as our sigma is basically equal to 2zr upon 3a0 equal to 4, so our r will be equal to 6a0 upon z, 6a0 upon z. So this is the radial node, and if we consider the angular node, so for this we have to equate the cos theta equal to 0, which implies theta is equal to pi by 2. Okay, so here we are having the two nodes basically. One is radial node and one is angular node basically. Okay, this is a radial node and this is our angular node. Now let us consider the options basically. So in the first option, it is saying that the number of nodal surfaces for 3pz and 3s orbitals are equal. It is true, both being equal to 3. The B option is the angular nodal surface of 3pz orbital has the equation theta equal to pi by 2. This is also correct. We have derived this. The C option is the radial nodal surface for 3s orbital and 3pz orbital are at equal distance from the nucleus. This is false. They are at different distances from the nucleus. And the D statement is 3s electron have greater penetration power into the nucleus in comparison to the 3p electrons. This is the correct option, because here we are having the nodal surface in the case of 3s orbital at 3 equal at this position, which is definitely less than that of the nodal surface of the 3pz. Okay, so in this case our electrons are situated very near to the nucleus NS, as electrons are having more penetration power. So the correct answer for this question will be A, B, D. I hope that I made myself clear. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.